Welcome to Off the Grid, where we are taking the gospel of Jesus Christ to the marketplace one spiritual day at a time. I am Leonard Lewis Butler. We're coming to a point where as we are stepping into the future. And in stepping into the future, I want to say to you, I want to look at some things in the past that's going to prepare us for our future. And those things from the past, when we look at especially that year 2020, boy, it was a very difficult year. And for some people, it was a horrific year. But 2020 left us some signs, and there were signs prior to 2020 for things to come. That basically means you have to have discernment of the past, understand what that discernment is going to bring you to so you can have understanding of how to deal with that last season. And if you can get the answers to that, you're going to have a better understanding for where we're going. So discernment is very huge. When I look at the areas of what has occurred in our past, I realized that there was a season of frustration. There was a season of anxiety. There was a season where our emotions were being attacked. And that had to deal with the news media. That had to deal with the politicians. And it goes all the way back to the time of Obama and going forward into Trump. That was some challenging times. In that season, you had fear that was going on the Republican side during the season of Obama. And then when you came into Trump, you had some challenges on the Democratic side of fear. And you're going through emotions, and there were things that will be tweeted, and people will get worried and concerned. And then when someone does something, if you're supporting them and it's out of order, you're going to find yourself being in agreement with a person that's out of order. And these were things that was just challenging. These were things that just didn't work for us. And because of that, emotionally, we're in a mess. Because of those kind of ways, the enemy, catch this now, the enemy, that enemy is coming in and giving us a system, and we're being jerked by the system or the atmosphere of the enemy. That enemy has brought in addictions. We've had opioids on the rise. We have alcohol abuse on the rise. We have suicides on the rise. We got so many things that's going on because of the atmosphere of the enemy. And so that's why I'm saying, based on all those things that have occurred in our past, guess what? Not much of it has changed, and the stakes are now higher. That's right. The stakes are higher. So if the stakes are higher, how are we going to deal with it? And that's what this broadcast is about. How we're going to deal with that area with the stakes being high. So what I'm saying to you is this. When you look at last year, when we went into that season of 2020, that was a season where when you're dealing with 2020, it's vision. And what I understood is the enemy to vision. That was one of the things that I was teaching on, is that there's an enemy to the vision. We know that we're coming to a perfect vision because everyone was speaking upon it. But what kind of enemy will show up that's going to want to deny your vision? And that enemy is fear. That's just hand in hand. Without a vision, the people wanders. Well, why the people don't have a vision? Because they are in fear. They're in worry. They're in concern. And so because of that, that vision that's supposed to be there isn't there. That's why it says, the Word of God says that the people who don't have a vision, they will wander. They will move where they don't know what they're doing. Also, the Word says they will perish. And so that's what we want to prepare ourselves for, as to how to overcome the wandering mind. That means we have to deal with that enemy known as fear. That's the ultimate enemy. But prior to that fear, it was an enemy that came after your emotions. It was an enemy that tried to put addictions to you. It was an enemy that offended you. All these kinds of enemies brought us to this place where fear came in, and we were useless because we were bombarded, we were beaten up. And so now we're in a season where we're quarantined, don't know what to do, many of us. And it's a bad season because there's no vision. But for those who have a vision in this season, boy, that is a mighty and awesome time. And that's the key, recognizing the vision for where we're headed. So I want to say this. to move into that vision, there's such a thing called faith. And many people say, oh, I got faith. Yes, I have faith. You got to have faith. But actually, we're not understanding what the reality of faith is. Let me tell you what that reality of faith is. That reality of faith is having the revelation and the understanding of how the laws of heaven operate. That's right. How the laws of heaven operate. Let me say this to you from an off-the-grid perspective. You have scientists that I have met, and doctors, neurologists that I have met, and I've interviewed them and they've interviewed me. And when I get into the conversations of how the signs and wonders operate from the perspective of testimonies, the one thing that I've gotten back from those who are worth their salt is that what you're saying is true. What does that mean? That means miracles are real. That means that there's a science that we don't understand happening. And so if there's a science that they don't understand, but we have access to understand, that means we're getting proof with understanding and they're seeing the proof without understanding. That's how valuable you are in this season. So you have a situation where people will say, well, signs and wonders are not for today. They're not coming from God. That's what they believe. That's what their religion has taught them. That is the system that they're confined to. And so that means that their only hope is through natural science. That's what the nurse said. The very first person who took the vaccination, she said, I believe in science. So when she said that, what she's saying is, I don't believe in God's science. That's the reality. So I'm not on that same page with her. And many others who are her colleagues are not in that same page. Why? Because they're seeing the signs and the wonders. And right now, the signs and the wonders, this is off the grid now, the signs and the wonders are accelerating. The signs and the wonders are overflowing because when there is an attack against the Word of God, when there's an attack against those who believe in the Word of God, when there's an attack, and that attack is emotional and spiritual, that means you who are with the Word, who have faith in God, meaning His science and how He does, that confusion is going to come and you're not afraid. That confusion is going to come, is not going to mess with your emotion. That confusion is going to come and you don't have a clue of what addiction is. You are locked into a different atmosphere. You're locked into a different law. You've been bought out of that process, out of that poverty mindset, and you're in a mindset now of overflow. What kind of overflow am I referencing? An overflow that when sickness come or when the plagues come, the type of things that we're seeing in our society, you don't have a worry about that. See, that worry opens the door for a type of COVID or something else to come, and now you have a challenge. But when you learn how to rebuke the worry, when you learn how to rebuke the emotions, the enemy that's coming after that emotions, but how is that possible? I said this to you earlier. It's going to be through that area known as discernment. You got to have the discernment. When you have this discernment, you can look at that enemy that's coming after your emotions. Sometimes your emotions will warn you. Your emotions might start to sweat. Your emotion might start to give you a faster heartbeat. Your emotion might cause you towards you getting a rash on your body. Your emotions might tell you, look, you need to go to the bathroom more times than what you need to. But guess what? Your emotions is letting you know that there is something wrong. So you need to pause there and find out, what is it that's causing me to feel this way? What is it that I am in agreement with that I should not be in agreement with? And when we get the understanding of that, we have authority with God's word, with God's science, all right? See, what God is doing with His science right now, it is so amazing. And this too is off the grid, but it's off the grid for a certain group. Let me tell you what I'm saying. There is such a thing that is called quantum science. We have a study called Quantum Science 2020. Check that out. There's going to be some really good nuggets in that. But in that area of quantum science, it's an argument between classical science and quantum science. Now, quantum science, basically, how I see it, is an exposure to how God's science operates. All right? How God's science operates. See, quantum science is able to move in miracles. Quantum science is able to move in thoughts. Quantum science is able to move in your words, all right? Thoughts and in your words. So in that area, quantum science is a science that they don't have a grasp on, but they know that it exists. That quantum science, they try to put it to where the computers are moving in that area, and some believe that the computers can do these type of things. There are computers known as D-Wave and CERN that can really do some amazing things, that can tap into other dimensions. But even in that, let me show you how awesome this is, it cannot measure what you have when you're moving in the science of the kingdom. And it does not come by observation as how science observes. So science says, look, we don't have an understanding of how it operates, but one thing that we do know, when the classical science shows up, right? Catch this. When the classical science shows up, this is what occurs. The quantum science or God's science, all right, or the science of faith, when they come together, classical science bows out of the way and allow the faith that is a law to come in and override whatever that is. Let me give you an example. If the doctors say that it's stage four, if the doctors say that there's COVID, if the doctors say that there's blindness, if the doctor says you'll never have your hearing again, if the doctor says there's rheumatoid arthritis, it's not leaving, there's nothing we can do with it, he is basing it upon classical laws. So in the classical laws, what he's saying is a fact. All right? What he's saying is a fact. But here's the thing. When you get what is a supernatural law or a quantum law that is activated, God's law that is activated, guess what happens? God's law comes in, the natural law moves out of the way, God's law says you will hear. God's law says there's no such thing as rheumatoid arthritis. God's law says you will live and not die. So that means there's laws that's in heaven. Better yet, there's laws that's eternal, and the natural laws don't have anything to do with eternal because natural laws are limited. Natural laws has decay. Natural laws is gonna decease. Natural laws don't have that kind of power. That's why the doctors are trying to figure out how to do things within the natural laws. But when we have the spiritual laws, we can show up and prove that it's working. We're in that season right now because as ferocious as the enemy does in the natural, the word says that the enemy is the prince of this world, right? And he has laws, and the laws that he has that he's controlling, he's able to do things a certain way. But in the doing things a certain way, we become an enemy to his actions. All right. I'm not an enemy to the enemy. I'm an enemy to his ways. I'm an enemy to his laws. I'm an enemy to those diseases. I'm an enemy, as the Lord says, to the works of the enemy, not the devil. He's not my problem. But what he does is my problem. And that's what I fight. And that's why the signs, the wonders, the miracles, the laws of heaven is on our side to defeat those enemies. Many people say that the law is done away with. I'm trying to tell you, no, it is not when you're trying to do miracles, because you can say that and you have given up your rights. So with that, what I want to leave you with in going into this 2021-2022 season, what you're gonna need to do is understand the supernatural laws. And when you feel a situation of fear, anxiety, your emotions being attacked, here's this, get this. There's also known as a law of peace, okay, or shalom. That is a protection. That shalom works with faith and also the love to cast out fear. All these atmospheres work for you. So that means you have a healing atmosphere for you and your family and strangers. That means that when the confusion and all these things are coming, guess what? We're gonna be well able. See, right now there are things that are going on where there is confusion, and I need you to observe it to see it. There's some things that's being exposed for you to see, and there's confusion. It's not for me to say it, but it's for you to see it. And when you see it, the words that I'm sharing with you, the words of encouraging, but encouragement and motivation, when you're dealing with it from a science of God, it is prophecy and discernment, all right? That's what motivation is, prophecy and discernment. When you're dealing it in the natural, it's just motivation, and it helps you to get up, but it doesn't give you the proper authority, whereas you get a guaranteed victory. Well, that's what we're talking about on Off the Grid for this broadcast. Listen, leave me some documents there, sign some words to me. Let me know what you're looking for, what you thought about tonight. And also, you can get with me and leave me a prayer request. However, I will respond to you. And make sure you subscribe. Hit like for us as well if you haven't done that yet. And thank you for coming in and being a part of Off the Grid. I am Leonard Lewis Butler, and I want you to know that Tammy and I love you all very much. But get this, Jesus loves you way more than that.